I play tricks with social media all the time. I like to see how things work, you know, and that's one thing about my career. For the people that don't know, like, I'm documenting my entire career. Like, everything is filmed, everything is screenshotted, everything, because when I'm done with this shit, I'm gonna put out the greatest documentary of, and the documentary is called Negative versus Positive, or the outcome of Negative versus Positive. And like with social media, I honestly believe the creators of social media had an agenda to make sure that this type of stuff get more attention than the rest of the stuff. For example, like on my Instagram, you know, sometimes I'll post unity, power, all races to stick together. We should be pro-human, not pro-race. We should be pro-human. Color don't matter. So I'll post a picture of like a bunch of, you know, different race hands in the thing. And it should get like 2 likes, so maybe 1 comment like, yo, you're the realest. They like, I respect you for this. And then, you know, I'll post some stupid shit like, I don't know, me in the bathtub with an AK. In a bubble bath, shaving my legs with an AK, and the shit get like fucking 3,000 comments. Like, you get what I'm saying? It's like, it's almost like social media is not designed for positivity neither. It sucks, like, that's the way the world works, like, because, like, time after time, I sit in my room or I sit in my house and I look for outlets. Like, how the fuck can you push a positive message to the world? Like, what's the best way to push a positive message to the world? And that shit is like, it's almost impossible. Like, it's almost like positivity has become unattractive, like extremely unattractive. Like, let's take, you know, a person like Brother Polite. So a lot of people don't know who Brother Polite is, but like, he's a person that is, he has a lot of knowledge and a lot of things. He actually just did a Breakfast Club, and it's probably one of the greatest Breakfast Club interviews that's ever been put out as far as the things that he spoke on. It sucks to know that, like, a person of his kind is not getting promoted nationally. You don't see MTV picking it up. You don't see, you know, World Star. You might see World Star, but you don't see, like, certain outlets. Like, they make sure that they don't blast those type of people to the world. I'm starting to understand, like, the media in itself has an agenda to make sure it cover up motherfuckers with a positive message. Let's take another example, you know. Let's take another big example. Let's take, you know, a person like my man David Banner. Let's take, because I'm very cool with David Banner. As you see, he has extremely grown in consciousness. Like, his consciousness level went from like a pimp to like he's there now. But is MTV and all that shit still pumping? You know what I mean? Is they like, yo, you need to check out David Banner on his new consciousness mission? Fuck no. Is all these fucking other sites like, yo, check out David Banner? Fuck no. You know who they telling you to check out? Lil Yachty, Lil Uzi. Check out these motherfuckers, because what they talking about? Nothing. I so much ain't all the money, so to say. 21. What? It's an agenda, man. This whole freshman class, I said in one of my verses, they load and dread heads to mold the youth. That's what they doing, bro. So, I mean, I'm not discrediting nobody, because I know some people that know Lil Yachty personally. And they said the kid is very ingenious behind what you see. His character is something that he has to do to get on. Like, you know, you got to think, some of these dudes are, you think designer really, really be sitting at home going, duh. No, it's part of a character. All of this shit is part. I just seen a video of designer rapping before. He was some shit he did in the room before he did the panda shit. He did the panda shit, and now he in his character because he know this shit gonna sell. Everybody wanna be positive, but most people know, like, being positive is not gonna get you nowhere. When the last time you seen a fucking label sign a fucking positive rapper? Look how long it took Kendrick to come out. A lot of people don't know that. Kendrick been in the industry for a long time. Long time. And I don't even think the industry wanted to put him out. I think the his people put him out, and then the industry jumped on it once it caught fire. So, you know, I just believe, like, negativity is at an all-time high right now. You know, that's why you have World Star. That's why you have all these sites that's singly pumping negativity and nothing positive. So me just understanding, like, positivity didn't get me that far. And for all the people that watch me, they'll know, like, I started my career off completely positive. I started off with one of my most known songs. It's called Daylight, I Am Swan. It's very positive. another song called Letter to Obama, Black Mormon. Like, I had a lot of music that was very, very positive. This was before the wild day. Like, this was like, you know, like I was pumping, like, yo, this is what we need to be doing as a people. I was literally one of those rappers, like, hey, check out my music. Hey, can you retweet me? Hey. And you know, it just doesn't work like that. People just, like, positivity is not attractive in this world as of right now. I mean, we're slowly on like a consciousness shift. Like, a lot of people are starting to wake up. Big shouts out to my man Chingy. I just spoke to Chingy recently. He's there too. You know what I mean? A lot of people are starting to wake up. Also big shouts out to my man Busy Bone. He's also there too. Like, a lot of people is really starting to like unplug from the matrix that we've been stuck in for the longest. I'm noticing that most of the people that are unplugging, the media is trying to shut them the fuck up. And that's pretty much what's happening. So me, for the past, what, about the past 7 months, I haven't been doing nothing wild. I haven't been doing no crazy Vlad TV interviews. I haven't been doing nothing wild. And yes, I have literally watched my numbers drop. I watched all my numbers drop. Like, I watched, you know, videos or whatever going from 200,000, 300,000 to like 40,000. And it's because it's positive. Like, I drop a positive joint, this is all I get. I drop some wild shit, 400,000, 500,000. So I'm watching it. So now I'm just like, I'm chilling. I'm like, yo, all right, the storm is calm. I'm chilling. But I'm gonna get back on my bullshit very soon. Very, very, very soon. And it's gonna be a lot of bullshit. And it's not even about money with me. My thing is, I need to get people to watch me because I got something to tell people at the end of the day. You know, let's take a person like Tupac. Like, Tupac didn't start off, they never promoted Tupac as a good guy. Tupac got promoted as a thug. Fuck you, thug life, all that shit, that's what got promoted. But recently, you start seeing these interviews pop up of Tupac being extremely political. Where was all these interviews in the midst of Tupac's career? Because they're clearly from the same time. But the media expunged them shits like, nope, nope, we not putting this out. We gonna put this shit out where you arguing with the people outside the court building. We gonna put this shit out where you spit on the people. We gonna put this shit out where you got shot. But we not gonna put this shit out where you standing on the podium saying all people need to stick together. You know, black skin, white, whatever. Y'all not putting this shit out. So I get it, it's positivity, negativity. But back to the other case, like, if I can get to a status to where I am as big as a Snoop Dogg, or I am as big as a Nelly or a T.I. or something like that. So once you get to that point to where a label can't stop you, nobody can't stop you, you can build your own media outlets, whatever, at that moment is when you should really start putting out very, very big messages. Big House of T.I. been doing it, David Banner been doing it, Killer Mike been doing it. A lot of big celebrities are now starting to put out bigger messages, but I'm starting to notice, like, the more they put out the bigger messages, the more the rest of the niggas not really connecting themselves with them too. So it's like a chain reaction, man. It's like an inside war that we really fighting, like negativity versus positivity. And when you switch sides, when you go from the negative side to the positive side, like, that kind of side, that negative side stop fucking with you. Like, it's wild, man. It's like crazy how this shit works, but.
They did the show, this is when they formed Strange Music. This particular show, and I was a high school kid on that show, you dig what I'm saying? And I was supposed to have left 2 weeks later to win, turn myself in to go play ball. And I was like, fuck it.
So we get out the car, keep in mind our car wasn't on the road anymore, it was in the ditch. And we look over, we see dude's car, and I'm, you know what I'm saying, I'm fucking pissed. I think I socks. I don't remember what the fuck, because we were just comfortable, it was a car, right? We were warm as fuck, and then the next minute it was cold, bloody, shit's glasses everywhere.
Man, I hadn't smoked all day, so I was like, fuck it. You know, I hit the bong. I start feeling a little weird. I'm not even gonna front. Like, and when I went back upstairs to the hotel, you know, Hobson had one of his contacts in and the other one was out, and he was like doing some shit, and it scared the fuck out of me. Like, it just threw me all off. Like,
there's like four or five cops pull up to this gas station, and one of our guys was on the tour, is coming out of the gas station, sees the driver, and he's like, hey, what's up? You know, what's going on? What's the deal? Is everything all right? Somebody messing with you? Because we had been really cool with her. We had never had any beef with her. She's like, excuse me, I'm talking to the police right now. And it was like, oh, snap, okay, like, hold up.